today we are going to talk about functions. So we have already used the predefined functions in the first and second weeks. So today we are going to mostly talk about programmer defined functions. And we are going to use the input parameters. We are going to talk about the function header commands and their usefulness. And we are going to talk about header files again. So, structured programming is a problem solving strategy and a programming methodology that includes the following guidelines. And we know that we are learning C. So C is the most popular structured language. So in C, the program uses only the sequence, selection, and repetition control structures. The flow of control in the program should be as simple as possible. The construction of a program embodies top-down design. So what is top-down design? So you might remember at the very first weeks of this semester, we have talked about how to solve a problem with computers. We said that we have the problem. We need to solve the problem by using the computer. To program the computer, we need the programming language. So we have to solve the problem by using the computer and using its language. For example, C language. So what we have done so far is we solve the problem by decomposing a problem into smaller sub-problems. Eventually, we have a collection of small problems or tasks, each of which can be easily coded. So we are not gonna try to solve the given problem at once, but we try to decompose the problem into smaller sub-problems. So we have a collection of sub-problems. We are solving each sub-problem step by step, then combine the result. So if we apply this top-down design, so we can end up with the functions. Why? Because function constructs in C is used to write the code for these small, simple sub-problems. A C program is made up of one or more functions, one of which is main. You might remember that we spent many times talking about the main function. And we said that each program, there have been many, many, many functions. But there is a very special function called main, because it is the main entrance to the program. So compiler will start to initiate the code from the main function. So execution always begins with main function, no matter where it is placed in the program. By convention, main is located before all other functions, actually all other function prototypes. When program control encounters a function name, the function is called or invoked. So what we try to say is that if the compiler encounters a function name with a parameter list, so now the control will follow that function body. So it is called function call. The main steps to be executed after a function call: first, in the CPU, program control passes to that function, and in the function body, the body block will be executed. Remember the curly bracket? Remember all or none? Yes, this is the idea. The function is executed, all or none, the whole part. Then when the function is finished, then the control of flow is passed back to the calling function. Let's see an example here. Now, we have seen the printf function, which is located in standard input output header file. Here it's the main function. To use the printf function, we first include this library. Then in the main function, we call the function. So this part is called function call. This is called function call. Okay, function call. And this function is coming from that library. Okay, So in the function call, we know that the parentheses are here for parameter list. So the whole parameters are in between the parentheses. So this part is parameters. And these parameters has a special name. These parameters has a special name. These are actually actual parameters. So these are actual parameters. So this is the function call. This is the parameters. And these parameters are called actual parameters. So in that example, we used the predefined function so far, printf, scanf, and substat. And in the standard libraries, there are lots of functions, so you don't have to memorize all them, but you are gonna use a lot of them. So you are gonna need to get accustomed to this. Okay, today, we are not gonna talk about standard library functions, but we are gonna talk about today programmer defined functions. So programmers, that is you, can write your own functions. Typically, each module in a program's flowchart is implemented as a function. C function names follow the same naming rules as C variables. Remember that it cannot begin with a digit and it cannot use the any symbols other than subtitle and these kind of things. So you have to use the same rules for giving the function names. Okay. Now, in a function name, we have four important parts of a function. So if we are talking a function, so a function is made up of four things. The first one is name. The second part is behavior. The third one is parameter list. And the last one is return data type. And remember, in the main function, we have seen all these. What is the name of that function? Main. Where is the parameter list? Inside the parentheses. What is the return data type? Here is the return data type. Okay. Where is the main body or the behavior? In between the curly brackets. So we already know the name. We already know the behavior. We already know the parameter and return type. So this was for the main. Now we are gonna write our functions with the same rules. So we are gonna provide the return data type. We are gonna provide the function name. We are gonna provide the parameter list. And we are gonna provide the function body. So behavior means that how the function solves the problem. Okay. Now, let's continue. Here we have a very simple function. Okay. Now, first of all, before using a function, we have to introduce that function to the compiler before using it. So this part is called function prototype. This is the same with actually function header. Remember, we talk about the function header a lot. So in the function header, what we have? We have the return data type. We have the name of the function, and we have the parameter list. What is missing in the function head or in the prototype? The function body. Okay. So in C, when you write your own function, you have to first write the function prototype before the main function. Now, I will show you the main function right now. Here is the main function begins and ends. This is the main function. So our idea is to write that first we first write the include statements here, okay? Then we first write the include statements, then we write the function prototypes here. After the function prototypes, we write the main function. After the main function, we write the function, user-defined function definition. So this is called function definition. So what is function definition? Actually, function definition means that, look at here, function head, I will put here, function head plus function body. Okay, so function head plus function body makes the function definition. So what is function prototype? So function prototype is the only function header. So in the C convention, what we are doing in C convention, okay, in C, when you begin to write a new C program, in a C program, okay, what you do, I will try to again explain. Please try to follow carefully. First, we put the include libraries here. Then we put the function prototypes, maybe you are using 5, 6, all function prototypes. Then we put the main here, and then we put the function definitions here. Okay? So this is a convention in C. You have to begin with the include statements, maybe several. Then you put all the functional prototypes here, then one main, then all the functional definitions here. I think it is clear. So in that shape, you understand. First this, second this, third this, and fourth that one. So you have to write in that order. I think it is clear. Okay, let's continue. So here what I have already discussed, this part is function prototype because it does not have the function body. This is the main function because we already know. This is the function definition because function header plus function body. So here, what is that statement now? Now let's come to that point. Now, what is that statement? So that is called function call. So what does it mean? Remember that compiler always begin with, in any C program, always begin with main function. Okay? Always with main function. So compiler will always execute the main function first. In the main function, if there is another function like print message. Now assume that you are the compiler, all right? Now assume that you are the compiler. You are execute in sequence, okay? You are gonna execute this first, all right? Then you are gonna execute as a second step this. Now what you learn? Here in the function prototype as a compiler, you learn that there is a function name, print messages. It will not return anything. It will not take any parameters. Just you learn this, okay? And after that point, you have to look and find the main as the third step. and you begin with the main. In the main, you come across a function call, print message. Normally, the compiler will look first if any include statements has the function, that function, no. Then it will look at, as a second step, if any function prototype, if any function prototype has that. Yes, we know that print message is been declared. Okay. So at that point, the compiler will not continue with that. No. At that point, it will jump to the function definition. So after that function call, so we call the function, you will need to go to the, okay, you have to go to the function definition, and you have to continue with fifth and sixth. When the function finished, you have to come back wherever you left as a compiler. Then as a seventh step, you will do this. I think it is clear. So function call means that stop wherever you are, stop there, jump to the function according to the name of the function, jump to the function definition, and do everything in the function body. When you finish with that function body, you now can return back to function call and continue with that. Is that clear? I think it is clear, right? So please pay attention to this, how the compiler works. So first, I will repeat. Okay, so the first compiler will always begin with main, but before the main, you have to do include and all the function prototypes, you read it as a compiler. Then you begin with the main. In the main, if there is a function call, stop there, jump over to the function body, do everything in the function body, finish the function body, return to the function call, and continue with that statement. Okay? So I will clear. All right. So we have seen that in the main, actually. So I will repeat quickly. So that's the return data type. That's the function name, and that's the parameter list. Okay, so when you write a function header, so this is altogether a function header or function prototype, we have to put everything together. Okay, this is function prototype. Okay, now let's see our function again. Let me put, so this is function return data type. This is function name. We gave the name, okay? We said that it's gonna be print message. Nobody else, but we decided the name of that function as we decide the name for a variable, okay? And this is the parameter list if we need any information from the caller function, okay? And this is altogether called function prototype. All right. Now, this is called function prototype. But in the main, look at, this is the main function. Okay, this is the main function. In the main function, we can call the user defined function. Okay, but pay attention to that. Now, pay attention to that. If there is nothing to return, okay, so you cannot expect to something return in the prototype and function call. Now the function name must be exactly the same in the prototype and in the function name. So in the prototype and in the function name, the name, function call, the names must be the same, and the parameter list must be exactly the same. Is that clear? So So we already defined the function prototype here. Whatever you write in the function prototype as a return type, as a function name, as a parameter list must be proper with the all the things that you in the function call. So you see there is nothing to return in the function call. The name of the function exactly the same, and there is no parameter because in the function prototype there is nothing. So you have to check all these three things. All right, let's continue. So basically, a function call is the name of the function with the parameters. A function call is the function name with the parameter list. Look, everybody knows that printf is a function and it's a function name, and parentheses are for the parameter list. So this is the parameter list. So altogether is a command, is a statement, because it's ending with a semicolon. So in that statement, it's a function call. Why? Because we know that it is a function. We know that. And we provide the parameters to that function. So it's a function call. When there is a function call, okay, you have to stop at that point as a compiler. You have to stop. You need to go to the body of that function. Until this function is finish, you need to wait until it finish. When it finish, it will return wherever it stops. Then you continue with the next statement. All right. We already discussed this. So let's see the general function definition. We already discussed this. So in the function definition, we have the return type, data type, function name, proper name as a variable name like a parameter. There are the number of parameters, how many now, n number. Then in the function body, there are the curly brackets. So this is the function body. This is the function header. This is the function header. Okay. And altogether, this is the function definition. Yes. Okay. So there are some functions with no parameters. So if there is no parameter, you can write the void as we did in the main function, or we just left space here in between parentheses. So it means both the same. There is no parameters in that function. Okay. But if we have the parameters, we need to give the name of the parameter and the data type of the parameter. Also, we can define the R variables in that function here in the function body, as we did in the main. Okay. You can write your function. So these kind of functions are called variables are called local variables. Okay, so local variables means that these variables can be used only in that function body. Okay. Now, if you have something to return, you have to provide the return data type. We already discussed this issue. So if we have the return type, for example, if it is integer, here as a last statement, you have to put return, for example, -1. Okay. If it is integer, for example, if it is float, you put -1.5, for example. Okay. But sometimes you don't have anything to return because you write here void. So as a last statement, you don't need to put the return here. You don't need to.
Because there is nothing to return. You said void. You don't need to put the return. But you can put this or this and there will be no syntax error. Even it is void. Okay? Now, there are some possibilities creating a function with regarding to arguments and returning some value or not. A function can return nothing and has no arguments, or it has some arguments but will not return anything, or have some arguments and return one value, or no arguments but returns one value. So basically we are talking about what a possible style of writing functions. Now let's see this. Now what kind of that function? So we can say that this function, let me say, takes 1, 2, 3. Three parameters. Okay, and returns an integer. Why? Because here. Is that clear for everyone? So what kind of a function A is? Function A takes three parameters and function returns an integer. Now, let's do some magic with you. Okay, let's do some magic with you. What kind of a function is that? So this function takes three parameters but returns void or nothing. Okay? Because there is nothing written here. Let's do another. Oops, let's clear. Another magic for you. Ready? Now, what kind of a function is that? This function takes no parameters but returns an integer. And this function, takes no parameters and returns no value. I think it is clear, right? But how can you decide that to take parameters and return some values? It depends on your solution. If you need some function taking parameters, you have to put the parameters. But if you want to return some value, you need to provide the return data type. So it is up to your logic. Okay. Now, let's talk about the parameter list a little bit more. Remember that this is the in between parentheses we provide the parameter list. So what can be inside that parameter list? It can be a variable, it can be a constant, or it can be a expression. So remember, what is the expression? Expression is a statement, including variables, constants, operators, functions. So this statement is called expression. Okay. So we can use variables, constants, and expression inside the parameter list. 7 is what? 7 is a number literal. Okay, a number. 3 plus A is what? 3 plus a is a expression. And what about dollars? Probably it is a variable. So in a function parameter list, okay, you have to define the function parameter data type and parameter name. Parameter data type, parameter name. Parameter data type, parameter name. And I will clear everything. Now, remember, this is what? This is a function header. A function header. What is in the function header? Remember that. What is in the function header? We have the return data type. We have the function name. And we have the parameter list. So these parameters, okay, these parameters are called formal parameters. So these parameters are called formal parameters. So what is the formal parameter? The parameters in the function header. What is the formal parameters? The parameters inside the function header. So far so good. Now let's continue. So what is that statement? What is that statement? This statement is a function call. So we are calling function. Which function we are calling? Tell me. Which function we are calling? Which function? Function A we are calling. But when we call the function, we provide the what? Parameters. So this kind of parameters are called, remember, this kind of parameters are called actual parameters. Actual parameters. So what is actual parameter? The parameters inside the function call. What is formal parameter? The parameters inside the header. What is the actual parameters? Parameters inside the function call. You see that? Actually, this is an assignment statement. So actually, it is a assignment statement. This is an assignment statement. Remember, in the assignment statement, right side, remember, right side is always a expression. And remember the expression definition? Expression is a statement with what? Variables plus constants plus operators plus functions. Now you see that in the first time, we have the assignment statement. Right side is always an expression. In the expression is a statement with the variables, constants, operators, and functions. Now you see that there is the function. All right. So there is the thing that we have to also discuss. Now, in the function prototype, okay, in the function prototype, we provide the function return data type, we provide the function name, and we provide the function parameter list. Okay. And in the function call, here is the function call altogether, we provide the function name, we provide the actual parameters. Now, in the function call and in the function prototype, they must be, as we discussed, they must be exactly the same. Pay attention here. Function name must be exactly the same name. The number of the parameters and their corresponding data types must be the same. And the return data type must be the same. So what could be the data type of result? What is the data type of result? Who could say that? It must be integer because function will return integer. So don't forget that. In the function prototype, okay, in the function prototype and in the function call, the name must be the same. The number of parameters and the corresponding data type must be the same. So tell me, what should be the dollars data type? It must be float. What about 3 plus a? It must be integer. 7, of course, integer. All right. So this is the what I try to explain already. Now, let's see a complete example. This is very important you understand how the function works. Let's go together. Remember in a function, in a C programming, we have something to follow. Okay, I will put these three things together again. In the first part, okay, we provide the include statements in the first part. In the second part, we provide the function prototypes, okay. In the third part, we provide the main function. And lastly, we provide the function definition, okay. So I will write for you again. The first part is libraries. The second part is prototype. Maybe there are more than one. And the other part is main function. And the other part is function definitions. Okay? So remember that we have to do this order all the time. So there will be here in include something. Okay, it's really important you understand this. Okay, so far so good. Now, let's do something together. I will clear all this. Ready. Now, we have to check that in the function prototype, and in the function call, here is the function call. Function call. The return data type, the name of the function, and the parameter number and their corresponding data type must be exactly the same. You see that in that example it works. There is nothing to return because it's void. There is no assignment here. And the name of the print message is correct. And one formal parameters and one actual parameters. Formal parameter data type is integer. And actual parameter data type is integer. So everything is good here. Okay. So you have to pay attention that in the function call, everything must be the same with the function prototype. Return data type, function name, parameter list, and the data type must be the same. Let me do some magic for you. Let's do something for you. Awesome. Okay. Look. I couldn't do it. Okay, now. Do you think there is a problem here or not? Yes, there is a problem. Why? Why? Because. Look. The name of the function in the prototype is not the same with the name of the
function call. So it will, there will be some syntax error and compiler will say that undefined function. Undefined function. I don't know this function. The compiler will tell you this. Okay? Okay, undo, or clear everything. Let me do something else if you like. Okay, let's assume that it's now float. Do you think that there is a mistake, error, syntax error? Is there any? Actually, there is no error because let's check it. Nothing to return. Now look at this is the function call. This is the function prototype. Now nothing to return, nothing to assign. Good. The name of the function is the same. The names are the same. Now look at this. The formal parameter, don't forget formal parameter. And this is the actual parameter. Okay. Do you think that? What's the data type of the formal parameter? Float. What's the data type of the actual parameter is? Integer. So is there any syntax error? Is there any syntax error? No. Why not? Why not? Anybody remembers? Because implicit type casting. Okay. Now, I have to say that in your life, I mean until you die, you have to use C language rules in every day. You have to understand and use C every day of your life. When you graduate from the university, you have to use C language every day, not one day missing. If you are gonna write your code in Python, you have to know the C rules. If you are gonna learn Java, you have to know the C rules. If you are gonna learn machine learning, you have to understand the C language. If you want to do database, you have to do C language. If you want to write down the games, you have to understand the C language. Without C language, you cannot become a computer engineer or software engineer. You cannot become. Because every other engineers will talk about this to you. They will say that, you know, C, in C it was like that, now it is like that. And you will not understand what they are talking about. They will say you that we are going to use now implicit typecasting here. And you will not understand what's going on there. And somebody will say that in the actual parameters, there is an error. You will not answer what's actual parameter. And somebody will say that in the formal parameters, your naming is not correct. You wouldn't answer where is formal parameters. If you want to become a computer engineer or software engineer, you have to understand all this terminology, all this logic behind the C. Otherwise, nobody would like to hire you. Nobody would like to pay your salary. Believe me. Okay, I will continue. Okay. So we already discussed these things. Now, let's pay attention here. What is this part? What is this part? What is that? What is that? Function? Prototype? Function header? No. What is that? Function definition. Because it has the function header and function body. So header plus body makes the
function definition. Okay. Now, in that function definition, you see that there is a variable. And this kind of variables are called local variables. Local variable. Why it is local? Local means belongs to somewhere. Because this integer I belongs only print message function. This I variable only lives in the scope of these two curly brackets. Other out of these function definition, nobody knows about I. I is only defined and can be used inside the function body. So this is called local variable. It's very important. Now, let's see some example. So in that example, what we have seen that there is the include statement, there is the function prototype, and there is the main function, and there is the function call. Okay, so check the function and function call together. If the void is void, no problem. Print message the same. One parameter, one parameter. Integer, integer. We already checked, so we can run this. Okay. So you can check this. And already we see this standard input output header file mat. Header file standard in the, you remember these? So you have to, these are called the standard library functions. So you can check these standard library functions and understand all these. Okay. Remember square root from the mat. So this is the same way we use it. Okay.